JavaScript is technically an object-oriented language, although if you come from another object-oriented language, you'll find JavaScript to be pretty sloppy. Never mind that. JavaScript's loosey-goosey attitude towards object orientation is a feature, not a bug. Objects are used when we want to create a cluster of related data for something and maybe perform some actions or operations on that data. In a more formalized sense, objects are data models that allow us to combine properties and methods for a specific data set in a structured way. The easiest way to make sense of this is to create an object. The course you're watching right now is a good candidate for an object. It has a bunch of different pieces of data that all relate back to the course, and we should be able to access all of or any piece of that data at any time by simply referencing the course. If I were working with a single course, I could use variables, but if I had a list of courses, I'd have to use a multidimensional array, and even then it could become very hard to manage very quickly. Using an object, we can set up a model for the course data and then create custom methods to be used on any defined course object. First, we create the course object, which is assigned to a variable, and define it as a new object. Var course equals new object with a capitalized O and two parentheses afterwards. Next, we set up the object properties. These are essentially variables associated with the object. So course.title equals JavaScript Essential Training, course.instructor equals Morten Rand Hendrickson, course.level equals 1 for beginner, course.published is the published status, so true since you're watching the course right now, and course.views is 0 because no one's watched the course yet. I can also do this using a shorthand. Var course equals curly bracket title colon JavaScript Essential Training, instructor colon Morten Rand Hendrickson, and so on. Now I can retrieve the entire course object by simply calling it console log course. And I can retrieve any of its properties by specifying that property, console log course.title. Objects can also contain methods, functions that use or change the data in the object properties. For my course object, I may want a method for updating the views numbers anytime someone views the course. So I create a new method called updateViews that contains an anonymous function, and inside the function, I return ++course.views. Now, rather than a bunch of disjointed variables and functions, we have a single contained object called course with the properties title, instructor, level, published, and views, and the method updateViews, which updates the views number.